Welcome back to my channel, guys. My name is Chrissy. Some of you have requested a skincare routine video. I did it about a month and a half ago, but I was not very happy with it, so I didn't post it eventually. Then I got very swamped with a lot of things going on in my life. I am very glad today that I could finally sit down and do the skincare routine video for you. So if you are interested, please keep on watching. My morning and evening skincare routines are very similar, except that I do not wear sunscreen in the evening. I don't think anybody does. And I start my routine with washing my face using a cleanser. Right now, I'm using All Clean Balm by Haemish. I'm trying to finish it. I used to think that using a cleanser unnecessarily would strip off the moisture barrier of your skin. So I avoided cleanser at all costs, except when I wear makeup and I need to remove the makeup and I go through double cleansing steps. But other than that, I used to only wash my face in the morning and in the evening only with water. Until one time I watched a video by a dermatologist and she said that if you have to use hand soaps to wash your hands, what makes you think that washing your face with only water is good enough? Yeah, she got a point. So then from that point forward, I start using cleanser, like just one simple mild cleanser for my face in the morning. You know, after you get up, you wash it, you know, your face, and then you apply skincare. So I use a more like a very simple cleanser for that. I move on with toner or lotion. Right now, I'm using two. Actually, I alternate them. I do not use one every day. I alternate them. Like, it depends on the mood. I don't know. But they're both good, okay? But then the price point, the price tag of these two are totally different. One is on the very expensive side, and the other one is more affordable spectrum. So I'm using here La Mer, the treatment lotion, and or the Mugwort essence from I Am From. That is a Korean brand. This one is 100% mugwort. If you follow K-beauty, I'm pretty sure that you have heard this brand and you have seen this bottle before. I have used this one for about 2 months. My very first impression about this one is that it's very calming. If you have redness, this one will help a lot with your redness. When it comes to hydration, this one is a decent toner for hydration. I wouldn't say it's very moisturizing. I have used this one for about 2 months and this one for about almost a year, about 10 months. I picked this up at an airport, so it's duty-free. When I came back to Asia, so I picked it up at an airport. This one is La Mer, the treatment lotion. If you're not familiar, this one, I think it's 150 ml, this bottle. And this bottle is, I think it's 100. This one is 160 ml. This one is 150. The price tag is very different. I think this one is 200 something. And this one I got from YesStyle. It's only for, I think, about $30 Canadian dollars. I'm not sure, don't quote me on that. It depends on, sometimes YesStyle have a very good sale going on and you can get it for a very good deal. So again, I alternate between these two toners. This one, even though it advertised as a lotion, but I think it acts more like a toner. It balances out the moisture level on my skin and it gives me a very good hydration. None of these two give me a wow effect, like, you know, like you can see the difference in your skin. None of these does that kind of thing. In my experience, I find this one a little bit more hydration. The La Mer is more hydration as compared to Mugwort essence. But when my skin is acting up, like, you know, very dry and have redness, then the Mugwort essence help a lot with the redness. This one doesn't help much with the redness. Just wanna point out. When it comes to toner or lotion, I normally don't use just one layer. I usually use like about 2 to 3 layers. So I give a good like 2 to 3 seconds before I apply the next layer. So yeah, either this one or this one. Sometimes I feel like I mix it. So I use one layer of this and one layer of this. And it works very fine. No irritation or anything. So these are good. Good to try. So then after toner or lotion, I move on to serums. Right now, I'm having 3 serums. I actually have 4, but the other one I haven't tried, so I can't really speak how good it is or anything. But this one I have used for a good amount of time. I have the Clé de Peau Serum. This one is on an expensive side. This one is the Shiseido one, Shiseido Power Infusing Concentrate. This one is more like at the average spectrum when it comes to price tag. And the last one, the third one, is Ampoule Peptide Shot. This one is a Korean brand. I have used this peptide shot for about 2 or 3 months. And I would say that it helped with hydration. It helps boosting the hydration level, and it gives you a very good glow. If you're not very into, you know, the hydration feeling, you know, if you have oily skin, you may want to stay away from it. Even though people said that peptide is very good for your skin, it helps with anti-aging, you know, in the long run, it's not something that can help you, you know, right away over the night or over a month. So far, I've used this one for a few months, and I'm not very confident speaking about its power or its effectiveness when it comes to anti-aging. I have a bit of the not fine line, not wrinkles, but yeah, I think probably fine line around the laughing line here. And I don't think it helped with this, but it helped with hydration. Every day that I put this one on, my skin looks very glowy. The only downside of this serum is that it's a little bit sticky. It's sticky to the point that you may want to wait a little bit longer before you apply a cream. That's my experience. And Clé de Peau Serum is very popular in the market. I think that this one is targeting first signs of aging. I can't really say much. I don't see much of, like, none of these 3 serums show me any effectiveness when it comes to aging, anti-aging. But the texture of each is very different. I'm going to show you quickly how this each serum looks like. Clé de Peau is the most runny serum out of the 3. And when it comes to stickiness, I think peptide is more like, is the stickiest. But then when it comes to texture, okay. So this one is Clé de Peau. The serum is very runny, not sticky. The texture is very thin. The next one is Shiseido. This one is a little bit on the sticky side, but it absorbs right away. The texture is a little bit thicker than Clé de Peau. And the last one here is the peptide serum. The peptide serum, the texture is thin too. But when you apply, it takes a little bit of time for the serum to get absorbed into your skin, so you might want to wait a little bit before you apply cream. These 3 serums, I would say that it's good for dry skin. Clé de Peau serum is also good for oily skin because of the texture and how fast it absorbs into the skin. So if you would like to try for hydration and you think about more like preventing, you know, fine line and wrinkles, I would recommend you to try the peptide shot. The Shiseido Power Infused Concentrate. Many people rave, you know, about this, crave about this, or rave about this. I don't find it very impressive though. I got it during a VIB sale at Sephora, and I'm trying to finish it. So would it be a repurchase? No. For this one, Clé de Peau, I really enjoy it. But when it comes to the price tag, I don't think it works that well to justify, you know, $300 or something for a bottle. This one is, I think, 50 ml. This one is the Korean one. I think this one is 100 ml. And I think Shiseido is about 50 ml. So these two have the same size. But this one a little bit, actually much cheaper as compared to Clé de Peau. This one, I think I got it for, I think 100 $5 or something. So these are the three serums that I am currently using. I alternate. Normally, I use two out of the three. I use Shiseido with peptide, or I normally use Clethopo in the evening because I think, you know, in the evening is when your skin is recovering, so it's better to give it more expensive stuff. But that is the only reason. When I use peptide, you know, sometimes I'm very lazy and I don't want to use sunscreen. But if I use peptide shot in the daytime, I would definitely have to use sunscreen. I read up on it, and peptide usually make your skin more prone to damage by the sun, so it's better to wear sunscreen. So that is the three serums that I'm using right now. When it comes to eye cream, I am using an eye cream from Kiehl. It is the Kiehl's Creamy Eye Treatment. I think this one, the main ingredient is avocado oil or avocado. This eye cream has been stable in my skincare collection for a few years. I think for a good 5 years. I have tried a lot of different eye creams and I still go back to this one. It is not because this eye cream is so very good. It's just because it does the job of hydration at a very affordable price point, as compared to many expensive eye cream out there with, you know, a lot of different claims. This eye cream does not do anything, or it does not do anything when it comes to anti-aging or fine lines or wrinkles. It's only for hydration. Especially when it comes to, you know, winter time, then I find that this is the only eye cream that can help me, you know, with keeping this area hydrated without paying a whole bunch of money for a jar. So that's why I always go back to this one. This eye cream is very thick, so if you don't like thick eye cream, you may want to stay away from it. Most of my products are very thick. Because I have dry skin, so then I'm okay with, you know, thick texture as long as it does the job. The eye cream looks like this. I know. It has a light color of avocado, but yeah, because that's the main ingredient. It's quite thick. I'm gonna show you here. If you don't like thick eye cream, you may want to stay away from this eye cream. But for me, because I have dry skin and all I need is just hydration for my under eye, so then that's why. And this one, I think it's about $38. I first used this cream and paid about $32 or $36, and now I think it's already comes up to $40 or $46. Don't quote me on the price, but I have used this cream for so long. The next one I want to talk to you about is a facial cream. Right now, I'm using Huxley Secret of Sahara. This is a Korean brand. And if you are familiar with Creme de La Mer by La Mer, then this cream, the texture of this cream is very, very similar to Creme de La Mer. You see, it's very thick. So, but it's very good at shielding, you know, like at providing a shield to seal all of the skincare that you apply before this. So let's say you put a lot of serum, you put a lot of toners, you need a shield to, you know, seal it all to stay on your face. Then this one does a good job at that. When it comes to hydration, yes, it does a good job at hydration or hydrating your skin. Again, I don't think it does any wonder when it comes to anti-aging or helping with redness or anything. But still, I love to try new products. So this is one of the products that I have tried for a few months now. I could say that I am okay with it, but it's not something that I would need to have, or I would run out of the door if I run out of it. Would it be a repurchase? I don't think so. It does a decent job at hydrating, and it's good for winter time. If you have oily skin, maybe you can get away with it. For me, this one probably is only good for me during summertime. That's how dry my skin is. So I'm still on the hunt for a good moisturizer, as you may have known. But so far, this one is good enough for me, especially when, you know, summer is here and the weather is getting warmer. So I'm good with this. That's it. So when it comes to skincare, I do one layer of toner. I give my my skin like a few seconds for it to absorb, and then I apply eye cream. At point I apply eye cream, and then I apply another layer of toner, give it a few seconds for it to absorb. During that time I apply lip balm, then give it a few seconds for the second layer of the toner to absorb. I then apply serum. So I either go two or three layers of toners and then two layer of serums, then facial cream. That's my skincare routine. When it comes to sunscreen right now, this is my favorite sunscreen. This is from Bonobagi. Not sure if I pronounce it correctly. This is a Korean brand, and this is more like a lab brand. Like a lot of, you know, dermatologists, they create a skincare brand. This help with healing the skin. It's friendly. It's actually very mild. I should say that it is very mild. It is designed for people, you know, just come out of surgery or having some sort of a skin problem, but they still need to wear sunscreen. Then this is very mild ingredients, I should say that. And this is the Milk Thistle Repair Sunscreen. Again, this is SPF 50 plus, and the texture looks like this. And this is actually, I normally apply about three times this amount on my face, and you can feel that it's very thin. It doesn't leave any white cast or anything. It gives you a good sheen on the skin, and it acts as a good primer for makeup as well. So I really enjoy this sunscreen for the moment. And that's it for my review, guys, or that's it for my skincare routine. If you have any question, please leave it a comment down below, and I will try my best to get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you. Bye-bye.